Hello friends, welcome to my channel Civi Concept. Friends, today I'm going to explain you how to calculate the dead load, live load and wind load on a roof truss. Okay, so this is my roof truss. For this roof truss, I have to calculate the dead load, live load and wind load. So before going to the example, I just wanna explain you the components of a roof truss. So this is my roof truss, right? This is my first roof truss. This is my first roof truss. This is my second roof truss, right? This is my first roof truss. This is my second roof truss, and this is my third roof truss, and this is my fourth roof truss. So this is the there are four numbers of roof truss. Numbers of roof truss in any shed, it depends on the your area, right? What area you require, or what area that your factory required to be shaded by roof truss. So there are the four roof truss, right? So the distance between two roof truss is known as the spacing of roof truss, right? So we will start from the component of roof truss. So at the end point of roof truss, or which the roof truss is supported, is known as the eave point, and the horizontal bottom horizontal member is known as the main tie, and the inclined member which is connected to the eave point, to the ridge point, is known as the principal rafter. This is the principal rafter. This is the principal rafter. This is the principal rafter, right? We connect the eave point to the ridge point. Then this vertical member which is connect the ridge point to the eave point is known as the tie. The height of a tie is known as the rise, right? The height of a tie is known as the rise. So this is the rise, okay, rise of roof truss. You can say that rise of roof truss. The height of tie beam is known as the height of rise of a roof truss. Then this is ridge point. Then this is the purlin. This is the purlin. The purlin is the component which connects the panel point of a numbers of roof truss. This is the panel point. This is the panel point. This is the panel point. So the purlin runs horizontally to connect the all the panel point, and purlin provides the stability to your roof truss, right? Then this portion is covered by the roof truss, right? This the covering of roof truss is maybe the asbestos sheet, or maybe the any steel roofing truss, or maybe other material you can use for the covering. So here is the roof covering, right? So the distance between two eave point is known as the span. That distance between two eave points, that known as the span. And this is the height of roof truss. This is my ground level, and this is the eave point. Distance between ground level to eave point is known as the height of a roof truss. So these are the components of roof truss. So I'm just showing you that the area of this sloping portion, right? The area between this purlin, right? This purlin and this purlin and this two vertical members, right? So this area is the slope area, and you can see that this area is the plan area, right? This area is the plan area. Okay, you have to remember this thing. We will later know you why we require the plan area and slope area. So let's move on to the example. We will see the one example that calculate the dead load, live load, wind load per panel point for a steel roof truss to be provided for factory at Bhuj with help of following data, right? It's required to be construct the steel roof truss for a factory which is situated in Bhuj, right? Which is situated in Bhuj. So we have to calculate the dead load, live load and wind load for that roof truss shed. So they provided us the data that the spacing and height of roof truss, means spacing and height of, means spacing of roof truss, that is 3.5, means this distance is 3.5, and the high spacing, high and height of roof truss, right? Spacing and height of roof truss. So they provided the spacing and height of roof truss. The spacing of roof truss, that is 3.5, and this is the height of roof truss, right? The height of roof truss is 12 meter, means this distance is 12 meter, right? This distance given is 12 meter, means the height of a roof truss from ground level is 12 meter is given, and the spacing between the two roof truss is given, that is a 3.5. now we move on to third data. There is a span and rise of truss. So span of roof truss is a 12 meter, means this distance is a 12 meter is given, right? Then rise of roof truss, that is given, rise of truss is a 2.5 meter. So this is 2.5 meter rise of truss. Then numbers of purlin including the ridge and eaves, right? Numbers of purlin, this is the purlin horizontal member. So there is a number, 10 number. So we will calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 numbers of purlin including ridge point and eave point, right? So numbers of purlin including ridge point and eave point. There is a 10 numbers given. I will explain you later how the 10 numbers are comes. So this is a sample. So length of shade is 30 meter, means this length is 30 meter is given, right? This length is 30 meter is given, that this is the length of shade we have provided. Then the roof covering material, there's the AC sheet, means asbestos cement concrete sheet. They given the asbestos cement concrete sheet. Then probable life of structure is 25 years. Terrain category and class, the terrain category is 2 and class is 1. And topography of ground is slope less than 3 degree, means the topography of is like the slope has the less than 3 degree, and opening of a building is 25% of wall area. So these are the some data. As we calculate the quantity of the dead load, live load, this all data we required in a calculation. So let's start with the calculation of dead load. So solution start. So then there are a total 10 purlins, and therefore on each side of roof truss there are 5 purlins, right? So there are total 10 purlins. So the total 10 purlins means each side, means this is if you divide this roof truss in portion 1 and 2, there is a 5 purlin and there is a 5 purlin, means here is the 5 purlin and here is the 5 purlin. The total purlins are 10, right? So how there 5 purlin, so I just calculate the, this is 1 purlin here, 2, 3, 4, 5, also 1 purlin here, right? There is a 2 purlin at this point, there is a 2 purlin at this point. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, right? Total 10 purlins as they provided us the data. There is a numbers of purlin including the ridge and eave. There is a 10 numbers, means 5 on left side, you can say that 5 on left side and 5 on right side, there is a total 10 numbers of purlins. Okay, now let's move on to the calculation of rise. The preliminary calculation. So first of preliminary calculation, we will calculate the angle of roof truss, right? What is the, this is the angle of roof truss, right? What is the angle of roof truss? So we know that this is this distance, total distance 12 meter. If you just consider this half roof truss, this will be L by 2. Just I just taken the this portion here. This is the L by 2, this is the alpha angle, and we have the rise of roof truss. Rise of roof truss is 2.5. So this is the 2.5. So we will calculate the angle. So we apply the 10 alpha equation, that is the rise upon span, right? Rise upon span, half span, rise upon half span. So rise is the 2.5, half span will be this is will be 12 by 2, means 6 meter. So we just take to the 6 meter here, so it will be 0.416. then just you do the 10 inverse 0.416, you will get the angle 22.60 degree, right? So we got the angle, that will be 22.60 degree. Okay, so next, that is the length of principal rafter. So length of principal rafter, so this is the principal rafter, right? This is the principal rafter. So as per the law of Pythagoras, we can calculate the triangulation, right? The under root of that, simply it is simple like this. PR square is equal to L by 2 square plus 2.5 square, right? So PR is equal to under root of L by 2 square plus 2.5 square. You can easily find out by this calculation. This is the length of principal rafter. So the length of principal rupture is 6.5. So this distance is 6.5. This distance is 6.5. Okay. So now we calculate the half plan area. Okay, so calculating the half plan area is important. Some of the material we are calculating on the half plan area, and some of the material we will calculating on the half slope area. So half plan area, what is the half plan area? So this blue color area, hatch area, this is the half plan area. This is the slope area, this is the slope area, and this is the half horizontal plan area, right? So what will be the area of this half plan? So half plan area will be L by 2. You can see that if this is L by this is L, so this will be L by 2, this is also be L by 2, right? This will be L by 2. Okay, and we know that what is the spacing of roof truss. What is the spacing of roof truss? Spacing of roof truss is given, that is a 3.5, means this distance is 3.5. okay, so what will be the area? L by 2 into spacing of roof truss, so it will be 12 by 2 into 3.5, it will be 21 meter square. That is the a half plan area. The half plan area is the 21 meter square, right? This is the 21 meter square. Then half slope area. The half slope area means this area. So we know that this distance is 3.5, this distance is 3.5, and the this, what is this? This is the principal rafter, right? This is the PR, this is the PR, right? This is the PR, principal rafter. What is the length of principal rafter? That is a 6.5. so it will be L by 2. It will be length of principal rafter. It will be length of principal rafter multiplied by spacing of principal roof truss. It will be 6.5 into 3.5. It will be 22.75. Right. This is our slope area. This is our slope area. This is our plan area. Okay. So we calculated the area. Now we will move on to the calculation of dead load. Right. Calculation of dead load is as per 875-1987 part 1. I will show you what how it look like. So this is the IS 875 part 1 1987. Okay, the code of practice for design of loads other than the earthquake load for building and structure. In this part you will get the other parts also, for lie load, wind load and earthquake load also. So for part 1 is the dead load, unit weight of building material and storage material. In this part you will get the unit weight of our building material, all the building material you will get the unit weight of in this example. So I will show you later that. So dead load is calculated as per IS 875. Okay, so first of all, calculate the weight of roofing material. The what will be the weight of roofing material? This is my roofing material, so I want to calculate the weight of this roofing material. So for AC sheet, assume the weight is a 130 newton per meter square on slope area. This roofing material will be will be provided on this slope area. So I assume the unit weight. So what will be the unit weight? We will use the ACC IS 875 for that. So okay, you can see that the unit weight of building material. So various building materials are given here, and you can see the asbestos cement sheeting, right? The unit weight is given in kilonewton, so it will be 0.13. so if you convert in is this in a newton, it will be 130 newton per meter square. That is right. So this is the unit weight of asbestos cement concrete sheet, right? So I will consider the right. So the in the IS 456 is the region 1.5 kilonewton. I just converted it in this into newton. So on the slope area, so weight of roofing material will be 130 into slope area. What is my slope area? Slope area is 22.75, so it will be around 29757.5 newton, right? This is the weight of my roofing material. Now weight of purlin. Where is the purlin? So this is the purlin, right? The weight of purlin. So the assume the weight of purlin is 90 newton per meter square on plan area, right? We are calculating the weight of roofing material on the plan area, not on the floor area, because it is not affected, right? Because it is not affected by the sloping length, right? So it will be calculated on only plan area. So weight, we assume the unit weight. You also get the unit weight from this. I am not showing you where is available. It is depend upon what type of section you are using for your purling. So I am not showing you where how to get this. You can assume this value as per your section is selected for purling, right? If maybe select I section, L section, channel section, maybe, right? So I am taking the purling weight 90 newton per meter square, that is unit weight of purling on a plan area. So weight of purling is equal to 90 into 21. 21 is the plan area and it will be around 1890 newton, right? So this is the weight of purling. Okay, again move on to the next part. There is a self weight of roof truss, right? Self weight of roof truss. So you have to remember this equation: 10 bracket span by 3 plus pi newton per meter square. This is the equation to find out the self weight of roof truss. So if you just put down the value of your span, you will get the self weight of roof truss, that is the 90 newton per meter square on plan area, right? This is the self weight of roof truss. So self weight of roof truss will be 19 into 21, that is the plan area. It will be 1890 newton. That is the self weight of roof truss. Okay. So next, that will be the weight of wind brassing. So what is the wind brassing? So wind brassings are provided in this. These are the all the wind brassings, right? This is all the wind brassing. This wind brassing is provided. So it can it may not be affected by the force of wind, and it may not be get cramped by the any load or wind force. So there is a wind brassings are provided in a roof truss. So now we will calculate the weight of that wind brassings. That this is the wind brassings. So assume the weight of a wind brassings are 12 newton per meter square on plan area. We assume the weight of wind brassings are 12 newton per meter square. So weight of wind brassing will be 12 into 21. It will be 252 newton, right? This is the weight of wind brassing. Now we calculate all the material that is used in this this roof truss. So we just total dead load will be 1 plus 2 plus 3. There is a weight of roofing material, weight of roof condition, that is the 1 2957.5, that is 1. Then weight of purling, that is the 8990, that is a 2. And self weight of roof truss, that is the 1890, that is a 3. And weight of wind brassing, that is a 252 newton, that is a 4. So total dead load will be 1 plus 2 plus 3. So it will be if you make the total of this quantity, it will be 6980.5 for one side of roof truss. You remember that we just calculated for one side of roof truss. So what will be the total load? So this is for only one side of roof truss. You multiply it by 2, you will get the total load on both the side of roof truss. So on each side of roof truss there are 4 panel points, right? On each side of roof truss there are 4 panel points, and on dead load on intermediate panel point or full panel point will be okay. How these are 4 panel points? You can see that there are 4 panel points. Means if you see that this is a full panel point, this is a full panel point, this is a full panel point, right? And this is the half panel point. End panel point are considered as the half panel point, right? End panel points are considered as the half panel points, right? End panel points are considered as the half panel point. So this is 1 2 3, and this half it will be 4. So one side of roof truss there is a 4 panel points. Here is the 4 panel point, here is the 4 panel point. So dead load on intermediate panel point or full panel point will be 6989.5 divided by 4. It will be 1747.37 newton and 1.75 kilonewton. Similarly, dead load on end panel point are half panel point. So we will just divide this full panel point by 2. So it will be 1747.37 divided by 2. It will be equal to 873.68 newton and 0.87 kilonewton. So this is the load per panel point as they required that find out the per panel point for steel roof truss. Means value of this end panel point is 0.87 kilonewton. Then value this is also end panel point, and value of this full panel points are 1.75 kilonewton, 1.75 kilonewton, and this is the end panel point means 0.87 kilonewton. This is the end point means 0.87 kilonewton. It will be 1.75 kilonewton. It will be 1.75 kilonewton, and this is also 1.75 kilonewton, and this is also 1.75 kilonewton, and this is also far panel point. Okay, so we solve the example by calculating the this. So if you like my video, please friend, subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel CV Concept.